let's go right.
Welcome to this bike mod video. Today we'll be installing the SW Motec Ion Footrest Kit. It's one of the mods I'm doing to make Red Rhino more suitable for off-road riding. So let's see what's in the box. It's actually quite a nice bit of packaging. Bunch of bolts, probably. So, set of instructions, a manual, I guess. Oh, that looks nice. These are actually the kit that I think goes on the bike. The first part goes on the bike. Looks really neat, nicely machined. Looks really nice. Bolts. More instructions. These are the rubber inserts. Some more screws and bolts. So these are the actual packs. I will show them next to the original ones, but especially for off-road riding. Okay, you can also do that with the original ones, but you need to remove the rubber insert. So for street riding, you have the rubber insert for a bit of additional comfort. When you go off-road riding, you take the rubber insert out and then you get a lot of grip. Because also the platform is wider for these packs, but there are also a lot of spikes, so you don't have any issues with if your boots are muddy or so, and you have a nice firm grip. Also looks really nice. Quite heavy. I think they're a lot heavier than the original ones. Yeah, looks nice. Let's go to the bike and install them.
This is the current standing position. Bent over a little bit. And I'd rather be a bit more like this. So let's see how much the foot pegs do. So the trick is to keep everything in, to remove it and then install it in the same order. First up is the split pen. You can also do it with a screwdriver. So this is the original one. You can also remove this rubber. Now get the new one. So as you can see, it's actually marked left and right. Thank you. then the seal goes back, if the ring goes back on. And then the split ring goes back. Fold back the split ring of the split pen. That's the bracket installed. If you compare it to the original one, not only it's almost, I think, 2 centimeters wider, maybe even more, but also it's a lot thicker, so way more support. So now install the rubber pad on top. So that's it. Now we do the other side. The only comment I have is, if you can see this, you're not able to use a torque wrench on this. And I think what I might do is actually shorten this pin a little bit. But okay, that's the spring. But that's about all the comments that I have. So, they look pretty damn nice. So now let's see how the standing position looks like now. Actually quite a lot wider than you used to be. Nice. If you like this video, put a thumbs up, subscribe down below, and I will see you the next time. Bye.